What up, guys? Been in the house all day, so I thought now that it's gotten dark, maybe I'll do a little bit of riding around, talk about some stuff. Transmission bumping a little bit. I guess because it's cold. I'm riding by Sean's house. I know his girlfriend's with him. That's why he's not hitting me up. It's not texting back. Hang on. Did I see CJ's truck? Oh, CJ's there. Nope, Sean's girlfriend is not there. I'm surprised. But anyways, changed the oil in my truck yesterday, and it's running a lot better. As I was saying yesterday, I did put transmission fluid in it, in the oil, because I was getting close to an oil change. So I just cleaned all that gunk and stuff out. And it sure did work. There's a lot of stuff that came out of there. It didn't look too clean. It looked horrible. But on the other note, I've seen some of my friends on Facebook. They was depressed about being single. I ain't gonna lie, I went through it. I've been through it a lot. I'm still single, but I stopped complaining about it on Facebook because it doesn't help. As a matter of fact, I'm at a different site. Nobody knows it's me except two people. They're my bros. They know it's me because I told them. But anybody else, they don't know it's me. It's just like a page that I put all my feelings and stuff on every now and then. It helps me keep my personal life off of Facebook and Snapchat and all that stuff. It's a really good way to keep things secret that you don't really want people knowing, but that you like just can tell the whole world without them knowing it's you and all that good stuff. But anyway, I was talking to one of my friends on Facebook about how he was posting depressing stuff on there and stuff like that. I don't want him to experience what I experienced by posting depressing stuff on Facebook. What it did to me was I lost friends. I had people getting mad at me. I was arguing with people all the time on Facebook because they didn't like what I post. And I was like, well, if you don't like what I post, you can delete me or just get over it or whatever. I mean, I was getting mad. It's crazy. It's stupid. So the new year of 2017, I'm not gonna do that crap no more because it's pointless. It doesn't help the situation. You're just wasting your time posting stuff on Facebook. Anybody that feels the need to do that, don't do it. Just hear it from me. Do not post depressing stuff on Facebook. The best thing you can do is just make you like a Twitter page or something like that. Don't tell people it's you. Only the people that you want to know, you can tell them, like your bros or anybody, but people don't want to see you depressed all the time. And that's what I've learned. They don't want to see your posts. They don't care for them. You're just wasting your time posting stuff on Facebook. So just don't do it. I wish I wouldn't have done it because it's messed my life up really bad and it's taking me some time to fix it. But I will get my life back on track. And I won't be being a little, I'm going to go ahead and say it, being a little bitch on Facebook. Because that's exactly what I was in 2016, a little crybaby bitch. I cried about everything, especially my relationship that I didn't have. But yeah, it's not a good road to go down. Yeah, and what was even worse is some of my close friends, they deleted me because I was so bad on Facebook with my relationship drama and all that bull crap. But everybody makes mistakes and you gotta learn from them somehow. And that was the way I learned from mine. So don't waste your time with self-pity. Just push it away and go on about your life. Things will work out for you somehow. You just gotta believe. I'm still dealing, it's still hard for me to deal with being single, but at the same time, I don't really care. I know that sounds crazy, but when you're not expecting it, the person will come that's made for you, that God has for you. That person will come. I kind of ran out of stuff to say, but it's foggy as heck out here. I can't really see anything. I just thought I'd go out for a ride to warm my truck up, because I haven't been anywhere all day. I've just been in the house, cooped up in my room, watching YouTube videos, watching McJugger Nuggets and all that stuff. By the way, I like his new series he's coming out with. I don't know what it's called yet, but he's doing pretty good so far. It's something like, he's snapping in the characters, and I've watched the video, like the recent one that came out. This guy was telling him to stop snapping, and he wouldn't do it, and he snapped into something bad. But I don't know how this is gonna go, but it looked interesting. I'm gonna have a wreck out here, because it's foggy as heck. I need to turn around. And I think it's time to change my brakes. They're squeaking like heck. Let me turn this defrost on, because this fog's killing my windshield. Golly, I think I just screwed up. No, I think I might get it. Just slowly pulling there. Oh, I made it. I thought I was gonna miss that turn. I really did. But I got it. My windows are starting to fog up so horribly. I think I'm gonna start being easier on my truck. I'm not gonna gas on it as much, because I need to fix some things on it. Like the front end. That's a major thing right there, the front end. I don't want to be going like 120, 130 in my front end brakes, or something like ball joints or tie rods snap. That wouldn't be a good deal at all. I think I'm about to go see what my bros are doing. But until then, I'll talk to y'all. Sometimes watching those McJugger Nuggets series kind of makes me want to do a series like create me another YouTube channel. Well, I already created me another YouTube channel. I haven't used it yet, but that stuff, it's hard, but they make it look easy, and it looked like it'd be something fun to do. And just to kill time. That'd be another thing to keep away depression and all that kind of crap. Just keep yourself busy and doing all kinds of stuff. Keep you occupied. Ain't got time to stress over women or anything like that. That'd be pretty chill. I've never talked about my personal life on YouTube until today. And this is probably the last time that y'all hear me open up about stuff like this. But I was trying to reach out to some of y'all, because I know a lot of people post their emotions and stuff on Facebook. It's not a good deal. Don't do it. I regret it. I really do. I regret that crap bad. If I could go back, I would never post anything negative on Facebook at all. What that does is it drains you and it turns people away from you. There goes Darnell. I tell you. But yeah, it turns people away from you. I can't tell you how many people actually deleted me off of Facebook because of my post. And it sucks, because they were cool people too. But I let my feelings, and basically what I did was let the devil take over me. Because that's what that is. Have you all deep in your thoughts and thinking stupid stuff and all that crap. But I let that crap go. It's the best thing that you can do. And I've got some of my friends back. I haven't got all of them back, but I've got most of them back on Facebook. And I'm not going to do that crap anymore. Thank you. my grandparent, like, this stuff got so bad, like, the depression and stuff that I was going through, it got so bad that my grandparents wanted me to see a doctor, but I wasn't going to do that because I knew I could overcome it by myself. There's no need for me to waste my time going to a doctor, and I'm not really good at talking to doctors and stuff like that, so that wasn't going to work out anyway. I could just tell them that right then and there. It wasn't going to work. But I appreciate them looking out for me and trying to help me out. But anyway, guys, I'm about to pull up to my bro's house, so I'm going to let y'all go. I'm going to go in here and talk to my bro, so I'll catch y'all later. I hope this message was helpful to people that are struggling with depression and having relationship problems. Remember, don't post it on Facebook. You only do disservice to yourself when you post that stuff on Facebook. Just don't do it. Just talk to a friend or something. You'll be better off doing that, talking to a friend or making you an account on Twitter. Just a secret account. Don't tell nobody it's you. And you can just post all your problems there. It'll help you better than just posting on Facebook and letting everybody see all of your problems and stuff. Just don't do it. But anyways, I'll catch you later, guys.